back to my channel. Today I am super excited about this video. I am going to be doing a makeup tutorial on this look. In my previous video I had asked if anybody wanted to see this look we created, and as well as my Instagram post, if you guys liked it I would do it. So this is what I'm doing. I have social media links that will be down below for you guys to follow, just so that if you guys want to keep up with what I'm posting, if I do a makeup look for the day and I just don't record it, I will put it up there, or products that maybe I bought that I just not gonna do a haul on. That's the best way to see it. I'm also in the works of working on a website, which I'm super excited about. So that will be up soon, maybe a week or two. It's a lot of work and it takes a lot of time, and I'm super picky about this whole thing. I just want to be for it to be perfect for you guys. So I will keep you guys in the link for that. Other than that, let's just get into this look. If you want to see it, stay tuned. I'm going to prime my eye with the Urban Decay eyeshadow primer. It's an original. I feel like my light is really bad, guys, so I'm sorry. I've just changed some lighting in my room and I'm trying to get it to work right, but it's just not working with me. I'm sorry, guys, hang in with me while I figure it out. I rub this all gentle all over my eye. I'm going to take my E22, which is from the new Elite Collection from Morphe. And I'm just going to take the 35F and just take this brownish color right here just to set over my eye. It's pretty much my skin tone on here. So I'm going to tap that off and just rub it all over. Doesn't matter how neat and blended in it is. Unless it's not your skin tone, then you want to kind of blend it in. But to get rid of any harsh lines, but as you can see, it matches my skin pretty good. So then I'm going to take my little palette here. This is just a Makeup Forever little one. If you go on their site, they have tons of different ones for really good prices. So I have a few of them. I'll put all the names below of the ones I use, but I'm going to take this this deep purple color, and I'm going to use right here. Sorry, guys, a whole bunch of brushes down here. My E17, which this is from the original Elite Collection, and I'm just going to take and dab it in, tap off the extra, and I'm just going to focus on more my crease area and downward with the for the darkest area, and then once I blend that out a little bit and get less off, I'm going to take it over the rest of the way. I'm focusing mostly darker on the outer and just taking it up a little bit. I'm not going down, just mostly in the crease and just above the crease. You can go as high as you want with this. I don't want it to be that high. I want that space in between. So I'm just going to keep it down generally pretty low and in the crease. And I'm just going to build that up until I get to the color that I want. And just keep doing that. Just take it into the crease, but do not go past the crease line of your crease. You don't want it all the way down there. And just keep doing it. Do a little more in the outer. I'm just doing circular motions to help with the line. And then I'm going to bring it, and then I'm going to do, once I get it in, like, all the way over, I'm just going to do windshield wiper motion, basically, to blend. And then I'm going to take my R38. This is from the Rose. I don't know if you guys can. R38, just to make sure, because it's a clean brush, just to get any, try to blend out any harsh line. With it being a really dark color, I want to make sure that it's a pretty. Get rid of that harsh line as much as possible. We don't want it hanging out there and looking too bad. Blending is the key. So it just gets the blending. What it does is it gets rid of all the lines, and it allows everything just to look like one smooth canvas. Okay, and then we're going to take the E28. Again, this is from the original E collection. We're going to take this lighter purple. And dab that in. Pop off the excess. And we're just going to focus more on the crease area and bring it down, like from to connect from the darker to the lighter, so that we can try to blend in the two colors. Now, this is a look that I recreated, and we're recreating from a video that I did. So originally I wanted to go with just this color, like this, but I just wasn't happy with it. So then I decided, when I was doing the look for my last video, I decided that I would add this really pretty goldish color, the gold color here. It's like a goldish brown. And I'm using the E14, which I believe this is from the original Elite collection. So I'm just swiping it on like this, packing it onto the brush. Tapping off a little bit of the extra, and then I'm going to go right over that lighter purple. And just kind of drag it across, sweep it across. I found patting this color on doesn't always seem to give the color payoff that I wanted. These shadows are very pigmented. They are, don't think I mentioned, the Anastasia Beverly Hills. They do work really good when you pat it. I just feel like this color, I really wanted like the deep color on it to stand out compared with from the deep purple. So I found that kind of like just like sweeping it on has definitely given me the color payoff and the intensity that I wanted. I didn't want it super crazy, but I definitely wanted it to stand out, to be seen. So definitely sweeping it gently. You don't want to tug too hard. Your eye is a delicate thing. But yeah. So I'm going to do it one more time just to get that color, nice deepness. I really do love this color. I didn't intend on doing an all shimmer look when I originally did this, but when it came out, as I was doing it and it came out, I was just really, really feeling it. Okay. And then we're going to go back in with the E28 with the a slightly darker color just to smooth out that bit on the crease. Actually, I took the wrong brush, but that's okay. I wanted the smaller one. That's okay because that actually had a little bit of a lighter color in it, so I didn't grab it. I'm just thinking of the colors that I used. So I grabbed the one that I used with the lighter, so I had still a little bit left over. So when I touched a darker one, it wasn't too dark. Like I said, the E31, this is from the original Elite Collection. They do have the same numbers, so if you go online to order it for this Elite 2, and you look up the E11, it will be this brush, except the bristles will be darker instead of white on top. Okay, so I'm going to take a little bit of this darker color right here and dab it on and go from the about not even halfway with the dark here and connect them. You want to connect it with the color that was here. And if you, like I did, if you doing your concealer and you by accidentally covered some of it up, which just goes to show how well that concealer works, just use whatever leftovers on your brush and do it. I'm gonna dab it in a little more, just pat it. I wanna make sure that everything's smooth. And then I'm just gonna take whatever may be left on the brush and drag it. I'm keeping it really close to my lash line. Since I already have so much going up, like big lashes and things, I just want to make sure everything blends. And I'm going to do the same thing on this side. More, just to get all this blended. And then just bring it. I'm not bringing it all the way, as you can see, about halfway. And then I'm going to take the same brush and just wipe it off a little bit. This lighter color right here, and we're going to go over the dark. Just basically mimicking what I did with my eye. Now I'm gonna do these two, and then I'm gonna blend it out with a brush, a clean brush, just to blend it all in together. So I'm going to take my another Morphe brush, yes, E36. For any of you guys who have watched me for a while, you're aware that I pretty much only use Morphe brushes. I do have a couple different ones, but I subscribe to them. So I get brushes every month. I did do a Morphe favorite, which I can link up here for you guys to watch. If you guys want an updated version of that video, let me know and I can do that. Just like to blend all of them in, just to make it a little nicer. Now I'm going to take that gold color. And I'm going to start right from the inner. This always bothers me. And then drag it all the way over. Dipping it in again to the same shade. And we're going to do the same thing to this side. Just blend it in. Drag it all the way across so that we have I would love to see you guys recreate this look. If you do, I have my Instagram down below. Just hashtag me in Sunshine Sotek. Tag me in it however you guys want to do it so that I can see the look. And you guys don't have to use the same brand that I did. There's lots of different, you can make different brands out there that people like with different colors. Or if you guys feel like the purple is too much for you with the gold or the purplish pink, I guess you call it, and you want to do something different but kind of like the same idea, I would love to see that too. So yeah, hashtag me in. I have my my Instagram, which will be down below, so that I can see what you guys have done. I would love it. Let's blend that out a little bit. Get rid of some of these lines. And this is the finished look. Thank you for watching, guys. I hope you guys love this look. I had so much fun recreating it, and I will be doing some more. So if that's what you guys would like to see, comment below and let me know. Thank you. I have nothing to say, but I love you guys. Bye.